I am Dr. Juliet Adongo, a pediatrician at TMR International Hospital. Today is World Asthma Day, and I am going to talk about asthma. Asthma is a disease in children. It is an airway disease which is caused by reversible inflammation of the airway. Characteristic symptoms is coughing, wheezing, shortness of breath, and sometimes tightness in the chest. Causes of asthma. Asthma is an inherited disease. It runs in families. Sometimes the cause may be not be known, but there are certain conditions that can predispose children to asthma. For example, children who are born preterm with chronic lung disease are prone to asthma. It is a reversible disease, so there are triggers. It is not always that somebody has asthma, but there are triggers which causes flare-up of the symptoms. And these triggers are found in our environment. For example, the environmental triggers of asthma, it's like the pollen in the air, we have dust. Other causes could be smoking, if you live in an environment where there's a smoker. Exercise can also precipitate an asthma. There is no definitive test of asthma, but other diagnoses could include lung tests, like spirometry, which is not really available in all facilities. And then there are some other lung function tests, which is used to diagnose asthma. There are two types of inhalers which are used for asthma. We have the reliever medication. This is a salbutamol containing inhaler. It is known as a reliever. This one is the one which you take to stop the symptom of asthma, like the chest during an attack. It is called a reliever. And then we have the controller. The controller, this is the inhaler which helps you from getting a bad attack, and it also prevents you from getting severe symptoms. To use your inhaler, it is not easy. Even me as an adult, it's not very easy for me to hold my breath. So in children, we use what we call a spacer. This spacer can be used by 5-year-old, and then there is a baby inhaler for those less than 2 years can use a baby inhaler. It has an opening at the end, and then this is the mouth spot. So before using your inhaler, you shake the inhaler first, make sure it contains the medicine. Attach it to the opening, and then the mouth part is put onto the mouth. Press one puff and count up to 10. That is 10 seconds. So, and then count up to 10. That is for 10 seconds. And then if you need a second puff, again press and count up to 10. Those are for 10 seconds. And then later on, you change. Sometimes these inhalers come in combination. It has both the reliever and the controller, like the formamide inhaler has both the medication in it. Yes, if your asthma is well controlled, you can have your exercise with no attacks of asthma. That is why it is important when you have asthma, you have regular visits to your doctor who is going to control your asthma appropriately, and you will live without symptoms, so you can have your exercise without any symptoms of asthma. This is the COVID season. Yes, having asthma, we know the people having asthma can predispose you to getting severe symptoms of COVID, because we've heard people talking about the mild symptoms and then the severe one requiring hospitalizations. People who have asthma are at risk of developing severe symptoms of COVID. However, in this season, we are still, research is still being carried on, because we still don't have evidence to support on that. Thank you. Thank you.